Hi everyone. Today's a bit of a dream come true for me. Back in 2004, I saw a review in Guitarist magazine for the Paul Reed Smith Modern Eagle, and ever since then, it's been a bit of a unicorn guitar for me. And today, unless something has gone horribly wrong, I finally get to spend some quality time with one. A few months ago, really kind chap Gary Randall let me use his 2004 double cut hardtail while he was away on holiday, just to see if it lived up to my expectations. And yeah, it really did. Absolutely mind-blowing guitar. So the opportunity came and I had to jump on it. So what is a Modern Eagle? If we have a quick look through Dave Burlick's excellent PRS electric guitar book, the 2015 edition, a few words in here about it. So on page 62, the 2004 Modern Eagle sat near the pinnacle of PRS production, just below private stock. Smith himself favoured the guitar for a time, and he described it as having a very balanced sound spread across all frequencies. If we then flip to page, I think 71, yep. The single cut trim Modern Eagle, which is what this one is, had a Brazilian rosewood neck and fingerboard, above artist grade woods, and a smoother, more complex and time consuming satin nitro finish. And then the specs. So the Modern Eagle. One piece Brazilian rosewood wide fat neck, Brazilian rosewood fingerboard, ripple abalone burned inlays, 22 frets, Brazilian rosewood headstock overlay with inlaid Modern Eagle, locking tuners, solid mahogany body, highly figured maple top, exclusive Modern Eagle colours, satin nitrocellulose finish, two humbuckers, RP treble and bass with covers, volume, pushable tone, three-way toggle pickup switch, and PRS stop tail or PRS vibrato. So this is the original run, 2004-2007. There was a few options. There was a double cut hardtail, double cut trim, and single cut trim. And this is one of the single cut trims. This is from 2007, so it's one of the later ones. And let's have a look. Actually, let's get the Sonzera warmed up. Just put that on standby. I always think this bit is the best bit, the anticipation of when you've got the box there. It's like when you've got a lottery ticket and the draw's been done, but you haven't checked the ticket yet to see if you've won. Almost like Schrodinger's guitar case. Except I'm hoping that what's in here is very much alive. So let's have a look. Excuse the view of my backside. Tan suede case and with some foam on the handle for some reason. Little brass plaque with Paul Reed Smith guitars and Modern Eagle. So these are sometimes shortened to ME1. At the time it was just the Modern Eagle, but since then there's been a few different iterations. So you had the Modern Eagle from 2004 to 2007. The Modern Eagle 2 followed in 2008, which was fairly similar, except it had a gloss top. It had normally 5708 humbuckers, but some of them had the RP or Ralph Perucci humbuckers that are found in this one. And the ME2 had an Indian rosewood neck as opposed to Brazilian rosewood. The ME3, I think, came in 2010 for the 25th anniversary year, and that had three narrow field pickups with a five-way Strat style blade switch. And then in 2012, you had the ME Quattro, which again had an Indian rosewood neck, and this time 5310 humbuckers, two of them. And then at some point after that, there was the Modern Eagle limited edition, which had two narrow fields and a 5708 at the bridge. And it was the LE that didn't have the Modern Eagle headstock inlay, but it had Celtic cross inlays, which were pretty cool. Here we go. This one's finished in Red Tiger, which at the time was Modern Eagle only. And there it is. I'm guessing that's Rio rosewood because it's quite light. Gary's, I know, has a very, very dark chocolatey Brazilian neck. Oh my god, it's really beautiful. You've got the green ripple abalone eagle. Headstock inlay there. Let's see what they mean. This one's obviously been played a lot because the top's gone glossy in places, which is, you know, a risk with a satin nitro finish. Eventually, that's going to buff up to a shine, which this one clearly has in places. There, special. I can't believe it, but this is magnificent. One feature about these that is a bit unusual, it's got square frets, which sounds odd, but actually makes a really effortless playing surface. So there we go. Right. The tubes should be getting nice and warm when the sun's airing out, so I'm going to say goodbye and I'm going to plug this bad boy in. So the trim needs a setup. It's currently flat to the body, and as we know from Skitchy, the bridge unit should be parallel with the strings. It's very out of tune. It could do with a fresh set of strings. Yeah, right, I'll see you later. Bye.